Inspiration 92.3 FM.
Good morning to you. Welcome to 92.3 Inspiration FM. The tea break begins now. It's another tantalizingly tasty Tuesday this morning. And well, hopefully, if you've had a frown on your face so far, it's about to get better. It's about to feel better. A smile is on the way. Today is all about the Naija women in business. And we have an amazing woman in the studio about to tell her story. Stay close to your radio. With me to the studio, Mrs. Ngozi Princewill Uche. Now, she is the MD CEO of her own etiquette and image consultancy, and she's been specializing in etiquette, image, and personal branding for the past 4 years. Welcome to the studio, ma.
Thank you, Titi. Hello, everyone.
So, etiquette, personal branding, image consulting, it's a world that I haven't had the opportunity to really do any research on. Could you, you know, just give me, in the most plain words possible, what is it you do?
Okay. All three are interrelated because it's all about your image, self-presentation, you know, how you put yourself across. And somebody once said that people buy you before they buy your product.
Okay.
You know, so the more credible you are, the more attractive your product will be to them. So I think it's something important for everyone to understand that you can present yourself, put your best foot forward, present yourself in the best way possible, you know, and that will lend even greater credibility to whatever message it is you're trying to put across to the world.
I find that really interesting, you know, because a lot of people have the business acumen. They know what they are selling.
Yes.
They know how to sell it, but it doesn't sell. Do you believe that what you do could help solve that problem?
Absolutely. You know, because sometimes your image, instead of reinforcing what it is that you do, is actually fighting it or contradicting it.
Okay.
You know, and that's something that people have to take a look at. You know, because we're all about, it's just the way human beings are wired. We're all about how things are presented to us. Mm. And I say this all the time, but this is why a perfume producer, for example, will take the pains to design all kinds of amazing packaging. Mm. And if they just put that perfume bottle in a plain brown box, it would smell exactly the same.
Of course.
You know, but they go to the trouble of putting it in attractive packaging and then supporting that packaging with attractive advertising campaigns and all that, because they know that we human beings, our five senses, you know, guide us a lot in decision making. A lot of decision making is emotional, and it's influenced by what we see, what we hear, what we experience, and so on and so forth. You know, so human beings, you know, connect with human beings. You know, so they'll connect with you more. And if you're able to tell your story and you're able to present yourself in such a way that your message is even more appealing, then it's kudos to you. It adds more to what you're doing.
You know, the amazing thing, just from what you've said just now, I feel like you're in the kind of field that could change a nation. It could change the world.
You know,
do you believe that?
That's part of the game plan.
Okay.
Yes. So we definitely want to influence, you know, society for the better, because we're promoting civility, we're promoting excellence, we're promoting professionalism. If you look at it, the undergirding attributes, you know.
Yes.
I'm